the 1939 undefeated St. Mary's Academy football team. The photograph was taken in front of the St. Mary's Academy school building, what is now the administration building for the Leonardtown campus of the College of Southern Maryland. One day, some years ago, Oliver Guada was in the town office and happened to be looking at the framed picture of the 1939 St. Mary's Academy football team. Oliver asked Chip Norris if he knew much about that team, and Chip replied, "I only knew my dad's version." Oliver informed him that in 1939, he was attending Charlotte Hall Military Academy and was the quarterback of the Charlotte Hall football team. He then proceeded to tell the story, as he remembered it, about the 1939 football game between St. Mary's Academy and Charlotte Hall School. The 1939 Charlotte Hall football team. And if you notice, in the second row, third from the left, is Oliver Guida. Charlotte Hall Military Academy was a perennial football powerhouse in the Maryland, D.C., and Virginia area, having won many area division football titles. For many years, Charlotte Hall fielded one of the only organized high school football teams in the Southern Maryland area. And when the 1939 football season was on the horizon, they contacted St. Mary's Academy School in Leonardtown, looking for a local team for a practice football game. The most remarkable part of this story is that St. Mary's Academy did not have a football team, and to my knowledge, has never had an organized high school football team in the entire existence of the school. But that did not deter the St. Mary's Academy High School students. They immediately accepted the challenge. St. Mary's Academy, being a very small school at the time, had to recruit the entire male student body of the high school to field a team. Those who did not play were named coaches, manager, and scorekeeper. The previous week before the game, the St. Mary's Academy team had a couple of afternoon practices and scrimmages and felt like they were ready. The big day finally arrived, and the nuns herded the entire team down the street into the old St. Aloysius Church and had them say a prayer before they left for the game in Charlotte Hall. Ah, we all know that drill. The nuns would never pass up an opportunity for a prayer. It was a sunny but brisk fall Saturday. One could say a perfect football game day. The team members met at St. Mary's Academy, and when everyone was finally there, most of the St. Mary's Academy football team climbed into the back of pickup trucks and the rest climbed into their cars and headed to the Charlotte Hall School football field. The trip to Charlotte Hall was a little different than it is now, traveling mostly dusty, rough gravel roads, as there were very few paved roads in St. Mary's County at that time. In 1939, there were less than 14,000 people in the entire county. The St. Mary's Academy football team finally made it to Charlotte Hall School and headed for the gymnasium to suit up for the game. This was probably one of the first local high school football games that many of the Leonardtown folks ever had the opportunity to see firsthand. So there were many friends, classmates, parents, and locals who attended the game. In fact, even though the game was played in Charlotte Hall, the majority of the game fans were rooting for St. Mary's Academy. Even my grandfather, Roland Duke, and his buddy Buck Goff showed up to cheer on the St. Mary's Academy team.
Give them a lowdown beat, and they begin dancing.
Charlotte Hall School loaned uniforms and equipment to the St. Mary's Academy team for this practice game, but they never really expected any serious competition from this thrown together Leonardtown team.
I keep cheerful, on an earful of music sweet, 'cause I've got those happy.
It was a very hard fought, rough and tumble game, but according to Oliver Guiza, it was a very low scoring game. Neither team scored in the first two quarters. Late in the third quarter, the Charlotte Hall quarterback, Oliver Guiza, threw a 40-yard touchdown pass, and the kick for the point after was blocked by St. Mary's Academy linebacker Harry Norris, and Charlotte Hall was leading 6-0 at the end of the third quarter. But late in the fourth quarter, the St. Mary's Academy quarterback, Jimmy Strine, threw a long pass to Walter Duke, who shook off two Charlotte Hall tacklers and ran into the end zone and scored a touchdown. And Tommy Chadrick kicked and made the point after, and St. Mary's Academy won the game 7-6. And there was much celebrating after the game. But what Oliver Guiza said he truly would never forget about the game was that the headmaster and football coach at Charlotte Hall were both very upset about the loss to the St. Mary's Academy team. In fact, because of the loss, the cadets at Charlotte Hall were denied the privilege of coming into Leonardtown for any events for the balance of the school year. Oliver continued to explain that in those days, this was a really big deal because Leonardtown was the largest town in the whole county, and it housed two movie theaters, restaurants, a soda fountain, ice cream shops, a hotel, and various social activities, including the Showboat Floating Theater, dances, and of course, an opportunity for the cadets to see the girls. Remember, in 1939, there was no Lexington Park. Now, back to the undefeated 1939 St. Mary's Academy football team, pictured at the beginning of this story. Listed here are the names of all the members of the team. All the members of the team and in the photo have now passed away. In 1939, war was on the horizon. In a few short years, 15 of those pictured were in military service in defense of their country in World War II. Two members of the team lost their lives. Captain Walter Francis Duke, a P-38 fighter pilot, was credited with downing 13 enemy planes during a three-month period in 1944 and was killed in action in the Burma Valley of India on D-Day 1944. Tommy Chadrick of the Army Air Corps was killed while on a combat mission in the South Pacific. Leonardtown's Duke and Chadrick Streets are named in their memory. Their names are also included on the World War II monument located in the town square. Joseph Harry Norris Jr., the late father of our town's mayor, served as an Army lieutenant. He was also called back to active duty during the Korean War. Captain Benedict Harris Sterling served under the command of General George Patton. He and his brothers Ernest and Linwood, better known as Possum, along with his brothers Hugh Dalton, Billy and Jimmy, and sister Nellie, served overseas in the U.S. Army during World War II. Kenneth Duke and Tommy Lawrence were naval officers, while Jack Hamilton, Francis Thompson, Philip Tuneman, Lee Van Wert, Bobby Thompson, Jimmy Strine, and Whitney Abel served in the United States Army. Both of the schools are now gone. Charlotte Hall Military Academy closed its doors in 1976 and is now the location of the Charlotte Hall Veterans Home. And St. Mary's Academy closed its doors in 1981 and merged with Riken High School into what is now St. Mary's Riken. And the Academy building and grounds are now the home of the Leonardtown campus of the College of Southern Maryland.